morning all of you. In this session we'll see another problem on this gate drains. Look at the problem. An epicyclic gate consists of three gates A, B and C. As shown in figure, the gate A has 72 teeth, internal teeth. Gate C has 32 external teeth. The gate B meshes with both gate A and gate C and is carried on an arm EF, which rotates about the centers of A at 18 rpm. Right, that means the arm which rotates about the center of A at a speed of 18 rpm. If the gear A is fixed, determine the speed of gear B and C. You are asked to find out speeds of gear B and gear C. Right? So this is an epicyclic gear train which consists of an annulus gear A. This annulus gear wheel consists of internal teeth of 72 number, and the internal teeth of this annulus wheel mesh with the external teeth of gear B, and the number of teeth on this gear B is not given, but this gear B is meshed with another gear, that is the gear C, right? But this gear C consists of 732 external teeth. That's what given in the problem. And this arm, this EF is the arm. It is rotating about the center of annulus wheel. Let us take E is the center of annulus wheel. The arm is also taking rotation about this center at 18 rpm. Okay. If gear A is said to be fixed due to the rotation of this arm, what will be the speed of gear B and gear C? That's what you are asked to find out here. Right? As usual, you prepare the table of revolutions of different elements in this epicyclic gate train and apply the conditions, then you will get the speeds of gear B and gear C. Right? So let us say EF is rotating 18 rpm. EF is rotating 18 rpm. Okay. Epicyclic gate train consists of three gear wheels, gear A, gear B and gear C. Gear A is annulus wheel. Right? Consists of how many teeth? 72 internal teeth. Annulus wheel, 72 internal teeth. And gear B is an external gear. Gear C is also external gear. This is also external gear. Right? So gear C consists of how many teeth? 32 external teeth. Whereas gear B consists of number of teeth and the number of teeth not given here in the problem, right? And it also consists of an arm. EF is the arm. Right? This arm rotates at rotates at 18 rpm. Okay, so that means let us take this arm is designated with the D here. I am taking D for arm, right? Obviously, ND is given. How much it is? 18 RPM. Right? You are asked to find out. So, to find out right, you have to find out speed of gear B and speed of gear C, right? And another data is also given. Gear A is said to be fixed here. Gear A is said to be fixed. Right, obviously NA is zero, it is also given, right? So for this, first you prepare the table of revolutions, right?
Right, let us say on the then gear A and gear C. This is gear C. So, right,
so in the columns we are going to indicate revolutions of different elements of gear train. How many elements are there in this gear train? Four elements, three gear wheels and one arm. Okay, now what is the first motion? First motion, arm D is said to be fixed. D fixed, right? You take gear A is taking one revolution per minute, or you can take gear C also. Now I am taking here gear A is taking one revolution, one RPM. If arm is set to fixed, what is the speed of arm? Speed of arm is zero, right? So then gear A is rotating one RPM. Gear A is rotating at one RPM. Then gear B, right? So first, you take the figure. So this is annulus wheel, right? And here there is a gear this is gear B, right? This is gear A and this is gear B and this is gear C, and here this is arm. This is arm EF. Here we are considering it as D. Now let us take this annulus wheel rotates in anti-clockwise direction. How many revolutions? One revolution. Anti-clockwise, you consider it as positive. One revolution. Counterclockwise. So obviously it is positive, right? If annulus wheel rotates in anti-clockwise direction, the external gear which is meshed with this annulus wheel also rotates in the same direction. That means the gear B also rotates in counterclockwise direction. Obviously, it is a positive, right? Now, how to write the equation for speed of gear B? NB can be expressed as NB is equal to, right? Gear A engaged with gear B. So, NB is equal to TA by TB into NA, or NB by NA is equal to TA by DB in terms of diameters. DA by DB diameter can be expressed in terms of number of teeth, right? So NA is 1, obviously this is equal to, since it is counterclockwise, TA by TB, TA by TB into 1, right? What is 1 here? NA is 1, NA is 1. Now AB is measured with gauge C, AB is measured with gauge C. Now you can write the equation for NC. NC is equal to TB divided by TC into NC, sorry, into NB. TB by TC into NB. So that is equal to, you know the equation for NB here, TB by TC into NB, you can write TA by TB into NA. Okay, so this is the equation for NC, TB by TC into TA by TB. TB, TB gets cancelled, then you will get TA by TC. So TA by TC into NA is only 1. Now, is it positive or negative? Since the direction of rotation of gear B is counterclockwise, gear C rotates in clockwise. Gear C rotates in clockwise because this is external gearing. So, if counterclockwise is positive, this clockwise is negative. Okay. Right, that's how the first row can be filled. So this is first motion. Then you go for the second motion. Once again, you consider gear D fixed. Gear D fixed. A takes X RPM. A takes X RPM. Okay, now once again on D is fixed, ND is 0, then NA is X RPM. Now here you will get, instead of 1 you will get the X, that's all. TA by TB into X, and here TA by TC into X. Now you consider next condition. Consider Y RPM for all the elements in the counterclockwise direction. Third case is Y RPM. Y RPM for all the elements. So obviously arm D rotates, gear A rotates, gear B rotates, and gear C also rotates. How many RPM? How many RPM? Y RPM. Now, Y RPM for all the four elements in counterclockwise direction. Right? Now, the total revolutions are total RPM value of different elements, right? Now here you need to add second row element and third row element. 0 plus y, you will get plus y here. Here x plus y, right? Second row and third row you have to add. Okay, now here y plus TA by TB into X, and here Y minus TA by TC into X. Okay, So this table you have to prepare. Okay, now what is ND value here? ND is 18 RPM. Okay, and what is NA value? NA is 0. So now you can take the given data, given that gear A is fixed. Given that gear A is fixed. Right? That is NA equal to 0. NA equal to 0. But what is NA from the table? NA is equal to X plus Y is equal to 0. X plus Y is equal to 0. Implies X is equal to minus Y. X is equal to minus Y. But what is Y? ND is on D makes how many revolutions? Y revolutions. So ND is equal to 18 RPM implies ND is equal to Y is equal to 18. ND is equal to Y is equal to 18. Obviously X is equal to minus 18. X is equal to minus 18. Okay. Therefore, now you take NC. NC is equal to Y minus TA by TC into X. TA by TC into X. Now you just substitute the values here. 18 minus TA value 72 divided by 32. Right? Into minus 18. How much you will get? 18 plus 4 8s, 4 18s. Right? 2 4s, 2 9s. Okay. Then how much you will get? Right, you will get 18 plus 18 into 9 by 4. 18 into 9 by 4. So, 2's, 9's. So, that's equal to 18 plus 81 by 2. You will get 40.5. You will get 58.5 RPM. 58.5 RPM. Similarly, you find out the value of NB. NB is equal to Y plus TA by TB into X. But you don't know the value of TB. How do you get TB value? So here you can write the diameter relationship for this, right? So diameter of this gear B plus radius of gear C is equal to radius of gear A. So that means you can write DA is equal to R DA by 2 is equal to DB plus DC by 2. DC by 2. So that means you can write DA is equal to 2DB plus DC. Right? But DA is equal to MTA. So the same relation you can write in terms of number of teeth. TA is equal to 2TB plus DC. Right? Now from this, you tell me the value of TB. TB is equal to TA minus TC by 2. That is equal to 72 minus 32 by 2. You will get 20. TB is equal to 20. Right? Now, 18 plus 72 divided by 20 into x is minus 18, right? Now it is 18 plus here 4 5 4 18. So you will get 18 into minus 18, you will get minus 324 by 5. Okay, that's equal to 18 minus 64.8. That is equal to how much you will get? You will get 46.8 RPM. But what is the sense of rotation? Clockwise. Because here you will get minus sign. Here it is counterclockwise.